whatever, buy your stuff, you're not plugged in. And we need to give incentives to U.S. companies to hire other U.S. companies. And if a product is made here, we need to be sure and keep it here. If it's not made here, and it's high tech, and it has a good future, then we need to get it here. But if a product is sold here, we should dominate the distribution channel. The final product's made here, until it gets to the end user or leaves that shore, it should be an American company. If it hits this shore from somewhere else and it's sold here, it should be moved and retailed and distributed by an American company. We're going to have to incentivize our companies here at home to hire other U.S. companies. We need to take a quick look at healthcare. We're going to strategically align healthcare. That's a term everybody's hearing. And I'll tell you what I'm having fun is listening to these political speeches now that are sounding more and more and more like my talk in New Orleans a month ago every time I hear it. So maybe I should have patented that. Strategically aligned means everybody in the organization understands where the organization is going and what's its objective and what's their role in it. In healthcare, we've got to have tort reform. We've got to have where doctors and hospitals don't have to worry so much about being sued or getting paid, and then they will have less need to prescribe duplicative or unnecessary tests. In Florida, we got started in that direction, but we still got a long way to go. I look at education. Folks, this is a big one. This is the future. When you really look downstream, we don't start doing a better job educating our students, the world's going to continue to take our jobs and our economic wealth. Now, I look at Florida. We all know Florida has a great education system, yes?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I read it. Number 5, number 7. Y'all see that? I see, you know, Florida's now number 5, number 7. You know what my first question is as an educator?
Number 7.
Now what? What? What are we measuring? You never tell you that. I taught a graduate class one time called performance measures. The idea was measure the right thing and measure it accurately and know what to do with the data. There's 2 standard national college entry exams in this country. Every student wanting to go to college is going to take 1 of 2 or both, ACT and SAT. It levels the playing field. How much did you really learn from K through 12 against the guy in California, Missouri, New York? We got 50 states in this country. Or is it 57? I used to know. Of the 50 states, where do you think Florida ranked last year in the National Standardized College Entry Exam with ACT, which is a little more math, tech, or science heavy? 1 out of 50, where do you think we ranked?
37.
We dropped, again, 47th to 48th. Now I hear people talking how good we're doing. I don't know what you're measuring. Let's benchmark it another way. Our state average in ACT last May, this year should be coming out anytime. I doubt that we jump in the top 10. Get the University of Florida last August. What do you think you needed to get in? About a 26 to 28 on your ACT. Guess what our state average was? 19.5. I call that a gap. What we've got to do with education is get serious and get the focus on the product, which is the student, and on the customer, which is the job market, and off the teachers. What we need to do is to have a seamless system where we eliminate this gap between elementary and middle school, and middle school and high school, and that big gap between high school and college. And we need to upgrade tech schools for those students that don't want to go to college. We're going to have to quit teaching high school and college and quit teaching first grade and third grade. We're going to have to elevate the curriculum starting first grade so that when they come out of 12, they don't score a 19.5. They score a 26 to 28 so they can get in our own state-funded universities. And we need to reach out to industry and ask them, what curriculums and skill sets and education and degrees do you want students to have so that you will hire them? Now, academia hates that. They need to get over it. And then we need to have them involved in the curriculum development. And then we need to have more internships for students in high school and tech schools and college get academic credit to go out and do internships in the workplace so that they can learn how competitive and serious it is, and then they'll be better students when they get back in school. Let's take a quick look at the serious threats facing America. My friends, we're under attack everywhere you look, inside and out. and it's serious, and it is not going away, and it's not going to all be solved if we cut federal spending. Make a note, cancer will not be solved either if we cut federal spending. Now, I broke these into internal and external. The first one on my list is, we got to get this federal spending under control. We got to get this government from bankrupting us. But we also need union management to recognize the fact that it is a global economy, not to be confused with a global agenda, okay? It's a global economy, and people are not going to spend more or pay more for a product or service just because it's made by a union worker. And we're going to have to get the liberal judges to stop making up the rules as they go and give our country away. We're going to have to elevate this education for our future workers and meet the global competition. We need the federal government to recognize the rights of our citizens and our states.
Amen.
We need to get these restrictive legal handcuffs off of the American entrepreneur and competitive spirit. Folks, we still have communism working in our country to destroy the family unit. And illegal immigration coming across the border. I have a tree farm. I have an ag license. And I'm going to tell you, I worked a little bit in money laundering, drug trafficking in another world. And it's ugly. The drug cartels are running Mexico. They find prayer rugs on the border. What don't you get? Everybody coming through that border is not looking for an ag job. You got radical Islamic aggression in our schools, in our textbooks, and trying to get in our courts and our banks. The growing black market that's been created by phony IDs, phony credit cards, and even phony voter registration. And you know, in this state, you do not need a certified birth certificate to get a voter card. And of course, the liberals don't acknowledge any of this or think it's just fine. Externally, unfair trade practices and currency devaluations and breaching of patents and stealing of technology by competitive nations, even in our own hemisphere, right here, Brazil breaches patents. And trust me, they want to become the largest agricultural exporter on the planet and take our role in that as well. These foreign goods are eroding our job base and our economic strength. The global proliferation of weapons of mass destruction. Renegade technologies. I was up at Tyndall the other day. Any Air Force guys in here? Ladies? All right, once in a while, you got to throw them a bone.
I couldn't stand it.
I had to go to Tyndall. I had to see the F-22 Raptor. What a platform. World's first supersonic stealth fighter. Can take on 25 enemy aircraft and come out victorious. For air superiority, it's replacing the F-15 Eagle, which is a 30-year-old airplane, which, by the way, again with American technology and know-how, has had 150 engagements against anything the rest of the world bring. One loss ratio, pretty good. It gets you in the Super Bowl. 150-0 and nothing. Okay? That's pretty good. I don't want to see one of those flying back against us. We remember when China walked out of Los Alamos National Laboratory with a set of blueprints to build an intercontinental ballistic missile to screw one of their nuclear warheads on. When they forced our spy plane down. These are serious threats. Right now, China is robbing us of our economic strength and our research, our development, and our proprietary technology. They will soon, with that kind of manufacturing capability and infrastructure and cheap labor and the robbing of contraband and renegade technology, start applying it for military capabilities. And you may have seen where they're already trying to put together a carrier battle group. Now, why does the largest country on the planet, with the most people, it covers 11 time zones, need the capabilities for force projection forward? It's not for friendly. We still have Vladimir Putin and the former Soviet Union with his vision to return them to their previous days of power and grandeur. We have the global black market on drugs, money laundering, drug trafficking, and black market oil. The bad guys have to pay their bills too. And when you look at this weapon of mass destruction, the former Soviet Union has the largest arsenal, and they go under, they need money, nobody really knows where it all went. You've got a lot of countries with a ton of oil money that want to buy the stuff. You think you could broker that deal? You got pirates operating on the open seas, cyber espionage, and of course, the ever-famous UN initiative, Agenda 21, the one world government wanted to tell you where you're going to live and take away your gun. And they're going to try to do it because of treaty. So what are we going to do? Absolutely. When you pry it out of my cold, dead hands. You know, part of my military career, I served under Ronald Reagan. He had a theory and a philosophy and a saying. You want to be a threat to us? We win, you lose. We need to work for less regulation and fewer rules. And in the U.S. Senate, I would work to decrease or eliminate the U.S. Department of Education and return that control back to the U.S.